kanuing ngā mahi ki a koutou. Ko tainui te waka tararoa te maunga o taki te awa Ngāti Raukawa te iwi, nei te huru rawa ko Ngāti Kuriki ngā hapū, ko Raukawa te marae, ko Joy Te Wiata tukurunga, nō reira, tēnā koutou katoa. Often when we think about manaakitanga or how we manaaki someone, we think about looking after them or caring for them, protecting them, and these are really critical ideas and important to Māori kawa on the marae and off the marae. And yet there are further dimensions of manaakitanga that are critical to the work that we do. When we look at the word manaaki, we can see two words in that quite easily. One is mana and the other is aaki. Now when we think about mana, we think about the ideas of status and of prestige and influence. And mana is a force that resides within us. And it calls us to be the best that we can be. It appeals to our humanity. It strengthens our connection with one another and our interdependence on one another. And then the other part is aaki, which means to encourage. And so we have manaaki, and when we think about that, we think about encouraging or urging people towards mana, towards actions of mana. And mana is also closely entwined with tapu. A dimension of tapu that we draw on in our work relates to restrictions. That's in our conduct, in the way we speak, in our attitudes and in our relationships. So these ideas are really important in our work because where mahi tūkino occurs, that's sexual violence, there is a physical violation, but there's also a spiritual violation. That is the violation of mana and tapu. And mana and tapu, they come to us through our whakapapa, through our whānau. So they're embedded in our whakapapa. So our mana and our tapu are strengthened or they're diminished by our actions. When someone has violated the mana and tapu of another, they're also violating the other person's whānau and their whakapapa. But it's not just the other person's whānau and whakapapa that they've failed to protect. They are also violating their own whānau and whakapapa. So the task we have as kaupapa Māori practitioners, as healers, tōhunga, kaimahi, is to support the enhancement or the restoration of mana and tapu, of whakapapa and whānau, of all of the parties. When we manaaki someone in our mahi, that is someone who's been responsible for violating the mana and the tapu of another person, ultimately, we are urging them towards identities of mana. Sometimes that requires a gentle encouragement, but other times it requires quite a significant prod. It's critical, though, that we attend to all of the relationships that have been broken down because of the harm, that we attend to the restoration of mana, of the whānau and the whakapapa. When we embrace manaakitanga, we work towards restoring the mana of whānau and whakapapa. The members who have been harmed, as well as those who have done the harming, and the wider whānau can begin to heal. If we fail to manaaki the whole of the whānau, those directly or indirectly impacted by the initial violations can't heal. When we do, all the individuals who comprise the whānau are able to heal and flourish. When we embrace manaakitanga, we look to restoring the mana and tapu of whānau and of whakapapa. We need to work with both those who have harmed as well as those who have been harmed in order to achieve that restoration of whānau and of whakapapa. If we fail to do that, then members of the whānau can't heal. If we do it, then all members of the whānau can heal and the whānau can flourish.